Okay, number two, we're asked to find the cube roots of z equals negative 8i. So the first step in finding the cube roots of a complex number is we need the polar form of the complex number. And the first step to get the polar form of the complex number is to graph the complex number in the complex plane. So once again, if I think of this as a plus bi, this corresponds to the point 0, comma, negative 8. So that's 8 units down the y-axis. So I don't need to go through any computations here. I can tell you what the polar form of this just by I. I'd have to go out 8 units, then I have to rotate around to get to the negative imaginary axis, an angle of 3 pi over 2. So it's not too bad here to get the polar form of the complex number. Now, the key to finding the cube roots, cube, remember, corresponds to the power 3, okay, is to work de Moivre's theorem backwards. In de Moivre's theorem, if you're taking a complex number, I'm just going to call it W to kind of, you know, distinguish it from Z. If you're going to take this thing to the third power, de Moivre's theorem said you take the argument to the third power, and then you multiply the angle by 3. You multiply the argument by 3. Okay? So, if I want to undo this, okay, if I want to take a cube root, that's like the 1/3 power, so the opposite of taking this real number to the third power would be taking the cube root of that real number. And the opposite of multiplying by 3 would be dividing by 3 or multiplying by 1/3. Okay, and that's how you start. So that's the first thing we do is I want cube roots. That corresponds to n equals 3. And we know from class there are 3 cube roots. And so we're going to call them W1, W2, W3. All right, so to get W1, I take the cube root of the argument times sys of 1/3 times the angle. So I get 2 sys pi over 2. Now how do I get W2 and W3? Well, you gotta remember these are evenly spaced throughout the circle. So the entire circle, you've got 2 pi radians there. And since I've got 3 of them evenly spaced, they're each 2 pi over 3 radians apart. So that means to get W2, all I got to do, I keep the R value the same. All I got to do is add 2 pi over 3 to the argument. So what's pi over 2 plus 2 pi over 3? Well, the common denominator there is pi over 6. This gives me 3 pi over 6. This gives me 4 pi over 6. So I get 7 pi over 6. So that's W2. How do I get W3? Well, I add 2 pi over 3 to this guy. So 7 pi over 6 plus 2 pi over 3, that's 4 pi over 6. That's 11 pi over 6. And just as a check, if you took 11 pi over 6 and added 2 pi over 3 to it, look where you'd end up. That would give you 4 pi over 6, that would give you 15 pi over 6, which you could reduce that down, dividing by 3, that would give you 5 pi over 2. If 5 pi over 2 is coterminal with pi over 2, so you're going to be back to W1 again, okay? So these are the three cube roots of negative 8i, but there's the that's the polar form. They want the final answer in rectangular form. And so to get back to rectangular form, we got to remember what the cis stands for. That's cosine theta plus I sine theta. So that's all we have to do now is to convert these back to rectangular. All right, let's convert these to rectangular form and then we'll be done. 2 cis pi over 2 is 2 times cosine pi over 2 plus I sine pi over 2, which is 2 times. The cosine of pi over 2 is 0. The sine of pi over 2 is 1, so I just get 2i. W2 is 2 cis 7 pi over 6, which is 2 times cosine 7 pi over 6, plus I sine 7 pi over 6, which is 2 times the cosine of 7 pi over 6, that's negative square root 3 over 2, plus I sine 7 pi over 6, that's minus 1 half. And so I get negative 2 square root 3 minus 2i. And finally W3, 2 cis 11 pi over 6, 2 cosine 11 pi over 6, plus I sine 11 pi over 6, is 2 times the cosine of 11 pi over 6, that's a positive square root 3 over 2, minus I over 2, which is radical 3 minus I. And I just see I spotted a mistake here. The 2's cancel out, and so I get that. So that'll do it then for number 2.